and was pursuing a career in acting. In 1989, Naomi finally married her longtime beau, Larry Strickland.
The thing that is so in common with Naomi and myself about our husbands is that they've both been in the music business. They were both in the band. Larry was with Elvis for a while, so they understand the business. Let's just get through this together, and I'll be right there for you, and I'll help you. That's the way Larry and Naomi are.
Life couldn't have been better for Naomi. Her rocky road from poverty to prominence was a fairy tale come true. Nashville labeled her the Cinderella of country music. But in 1990, Naomi's idyllic life suddenly came crashing down around her.
5 or 6 years, I felt not right. You know, where you just know that things aren't in place. A little achy, headache that comes and goes. I knew something was going on.
The 44-year-old performer underwent a battery of tests. Doctors finally discovered she had hepatitis C, a life-threatening virus that attacks the liver. There's no cure for the illness that can eventually destroy the liver.
They said that I'd gotten a needle stick with infected blood when I worked in ICU as a nurse. I remember looking in the mirror, sort of the mirror of truth, if you will, and said, "This is so unfair. So unfair."
At first, Naomi tried to keep her debilitating disease a secret from everyone except her family. In true Judd fashion, she continued working, sleeping all day so she could sing at night. Naomi got so weak that Wynonna had to dress her before each show. Doctors insisted she needed to stop her rigorous schedule, or she was going to take a turn for the worse. Naomi finally decided it was time to quit.
This is what she wanted to always do. This was her dream. And all of a sudden, and she wasn't, they weren't on stage that much before she had to give it up.
I'm Ken Stills.
On October 17th, 1990, Naomi and Wynonna Judd held a press conference at the RCA building in Nashville.
Today's pretty much the most difficult day of my life. I'm sorry.
I prayed about it for several weeks and then realized just how bad the situation was becoming for me. I have to resign, I have to retire from the music industry that I love so much.
These supposedly hardened journalists, huh? We had tears coming out of our eyes. I still get emotional talking about that. It was tough on her and tough on us.
That support, because I don't know what the...
The Judds immediately planned a farewell tour for 1991. It was their way of thanking their fans and saying goodbye.
I needed closure. I needed to say goodbye in the major cities to thank as many fans as I could because I love them.
Naomi loved the spotlight, the fans, and the music. But all that was going away. The ambitious performer who fought hard to secure a place in country music was now tackling the toughest battle of her life. 1991 was a bittersweet year for the Judds. They went on a nationwide farewell tour, 124 concert dates in 12 months. The grueling schedule was physically tough for Naomi, who barely had enough energy to get out of bed.
And tonight is not my going away party. I'm not going anywhere. You're the one that's going places. This is your going away party.
On December 4th, the Judds performed their last concert together in Murfreesboro, Tennessee. It was an emotional evening for everyone.
Gwen.
I was at their last concert together. I cried when before they started. Because, you know, to give it up willingly, just because you're ready to get off the road is one thing, but you have to, and you're not ready to give it up, I just couldn't imagine the pain of that.
Did lovers really fall in love to stay? Would stand beside each other?
When you're sitting there in the middle of a group of regular, ordinary civilians who just see them as these personalities and these music stars, and you feel this incredible outpouring of love, you'd have to be made of stone not to respond to that. The people cared.
I was watching my mother lose everything. I'd stand on stage at night and watch her say goodbye, and I didn't know, was I ever going to be able to say hello again? I didn't know what was going to be for me after this death of the Judds.
It was the death of the Judds and the rebirth of Wynonna. The Cinderella of country music passed her crown over to her daughter, but Wynonna had a difficult time accepting her new title. After the farewell tour, Naomi retreated to her Tennessee farm to convalesce, while Wynonna sunk into a deep depression. She felt alone and insecure. She wondered if she could continue performing without her beautiful and business-savvy mother.
All of a sudden, it's like, no, you're alone, and you're going to have to carry this by yourself. And yeah, she was frightful and scared. I think she was a person who was arrested at age 17 and had never been allowed to grow to full adulthood. And she had been so smothered and so hovered over that when she went solo, it was finally her growing up.
Within a year, the 27-year-old emerged from her mother's shadow. Wynonna's first year as a solo artist was a smashing success. Her first three singles went straight to number one. Her country and rhythm and blues sound set her apart from the Judd style of music.
I've been a rock and I got my fences. I never let them down.
The remarkable part of it to me is the richening of her voice. I mean, she's always had such an amazing voice, and that it just gets deeper and broader and more flexible.
I'm out of control. How did you get to me? No one else on earth could ever.
Another thing about my sister is the necessity she feels in her spirit for freedom and the kind of wings that her music gives her.
No one could love me like, no one could love me like you.
Wynonna has achieved more than just professional freedom. The once rebellious teen who fought so hard with her mother is now herself a mom. In 1994, Wynonna had a son, Elijah. And in 1996, she was blessed with a daughter, Grace Pauline. That same year, Wynonna married her children's father, Arch Kelly, a yacht salesman. They separated in 1998.
The hardest part was dealing with all my insecurities in front of everybody. That was the hardest part of it. The painful part was having to make all my mistakes in public and live my life in that goldfish
birth
bowl.
Birth is messy, honey.
And I was a very
birth
messy birth.
Painful and messy.
While Wynonna still shined in the spotlight, Naomi was home healing. She was determined to overcome her hepatitis, despite her doctor's grim prognosis. She says she battled the disease through a combination of a liver drug called interferon and spiritual healing. Against all odds, Naomi has been in remission since 1996. Doctors told her the virus has completely cleared from her system. Less than 10% of people infected with hepatitis C have been able to get rid of the virus.
I decided to get peace of mind for myself, and I began going on this search I sat at the feet of the most brilliant experts in America who work in spirit, mind, body work.
The former singing sensation established the Naomi Judd Research Fund for Liver Disease. She also lectures across the country as an official spokesperson for people battling incurable liver diseases. Through her illness, Naomi has given hope to others. Now she wants to celebrate her victory by doing what she does best.
Right here, please. Right here, please.
On December 4th, 1998, Naomi and Wynonna announced a reunion concert. The two have not performed together as a group for over 7 years.
It'll feel good to sing with Mom again because I've been performing the Judd medley on stage. I haven't departed from my roots that much. We're still as connected as ever.
Naomi has no plans to return to singing full time. She keeps busy giving emotional support to both of her daughters.
And Mom, because she's the best mom in the whole world.
Ashley Judd has made her mark in Hollywood. She starred in such films as Kiss the Girls and Simon Birch. The actress even sang with her mother and sister at a charity auction for the American Liver Foundation.
The Lord's coming, a good night. The Lord's coming, knocking at the door. The door flew open and the love comes streaming down, Lord, down, Lord, down.
The Judd women are proud of each other's accomplishments. At the same time, they're not afraid to point out their shortcomings.
Wynonna and Ashley and I are not ashamed to show our brokenness and to say we don't have all the answers. We're just three goofy, wacky girls who are very, very passionate about our beliefs, about our faith, and our love for each other.
Through their tears and triumphs, the Judds have become a permanent part of music history. During their 8-year career, they won countless awards and sold almost 30 million records. The beloved mother-daughter act saw their dream come to fruition. Today, their music lives on.
Let our dream inspire you to dream.
I doubt anybody will come close to their record and the things that they've accomplished in a long time. They're a rags to riches story, definitely, but most of the people in country music are.
Their music will be heard forever. Let's not forget that it's really, really good music. Really music for the ages.
That'll be a legacy that will always be there. Those records are going to be calling cards as long as people listen to music.
Because it wasn't just the mother-daughter thing. It's the music.